We are beginning tonight with our Commitment 2010 coverage and the race for governor. With less than 1 week to go before the election, a new field poll shows Democrat Jerry Brown has built a significant lead over Republican challenger Meg Whitman. The new poll shows Brown up by 10 points, 49% to 39% among likely voters.
The pollsters found that Brown has increasing support from women, Latinos, independents, and voters in Los Angeles County. Republican Meg Whitman, meantime, is trying to buck that trend, stumping for just those votes. And she's also bucking for the support of the ag industry. She took her campaign today here to Salinas.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the next governor of the state of California, Meg Whitman.
Jerry Brown, if he wins this election, is going to be the special interest governor.
With her numbers fading, Meg Whitman actually appeared to entertain the possibility that the $150 million she's invested in this campaign will be for naught. But in front of a group of supporters at DiRigo Brothers in Salinas, she continued to drive home her plan to stimulate job growth here in California.
My biggest priority is job creation. Think about families. When a family member loses a job, the family budget falls apart. It's the same thing with the state. We've got to get Californians back to work or we'll never get out of the fiscal crisis that we're in. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to decrease taxes so that it's possible for small family businesses to grow and hire people here. We're going to streamline regulation.
It's a plan, she says, will put most all unemployed Californians to work in the next 5 years.
2 million jobs is a lot of jobs in 5 years. And this isn't selling stuff on eBay. I mean, these, you talk about manufacturing. With all due respect,
sure.
And that's a good job. But,
yeah.
But that's a lot of jobs. That's almost all of Californians that are out of work.
Well, guess what? We have got to put Californians back to work. It is the number one challenge this state faces. And we are going to turn on the water. That will help agriculture. We're going to streamline regulations, which will help small businesses of all kinds. We're going to put in place, we're going to raise the R&D tax credit so that we hold on to every high-tech lab, green tech lab, biotech lab. I have every confidence that we can do this, but it's going to take a different attitude at the top of this state. We're going to have a business-friendly, a job-friendly attitude, which the state hasn't had for many years. But this is the battle for the future of California.
This Salinas appearance comes after Whitman and Brown couldn't agree to pull attack ads at a Southern California women's conference at the urging of NBC's Matt Lauer.
In 1 week left, would either of you or both of you be willing to make a pledge that you would end the negativity?
And while she continues to attack Brown, new numbers suggest he's had more success in attacking her, aligning Whitman with the failures of the Schwarzenegger administration and on the issue of immigration, an important one to the Central Coast ag industry.
Donna, this housekeeper thing's been beaten to death. However, you said that the agency, you put your faith in the agency and they didn't do the job, and so consequently, that's how it all went down. We live and die by ag here. These ag firms rely in many cases on agencies to provide them workers. If that agency fails to do the job or gets hoodwinked, should these ag companies, growers and shippers, be held responsible?
Here's what we need to do for the agricultural industry. We got to get a temporary guest worker program so people can be hired here legally, can work in the fields and other industries, because agriculture does depend on that kind of program. In fact, I was here, at this farm in Salinas, and one farmer came up to me and said, "I want to know that you're firm on that temporary guest worker program," and I am. So that's my solution. We have to secure the borders. We do have to hold employers accountable. We've got to eliminate sanctuary cities, but a temporary guest worker program is part of the plan.
Meg Whitman's stop in Salinas was part of a Northern California swing, which also included a stop in Stockton and the Bay Area. You can see my entire interview with the candidate on our website. You can also find more Commitment 2010 coverage, including polling information, candidate information, and more. It's all at KSBW.com.